Welcome to Week 12 of Football Fridays in Georgia here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. Tonight, we're in Gainesville, Georgia, where the defending 5A state champion Red Elephants of Gainesville will take on the Falcons of Flowery Branch. A region championship is on the line.
Also ahead on the All Access Pass, what's the connection between this little girl frolicking in the Swiss Alps and one of Gainesville High's most legendary players? Only the most infamous night in NFL history.
Knowledge is power, so make sure you stay on those couches because Trey and myself is going to drop a little knowledge on you.
And one of these players will help their team win a region championship tonight on Football Fridays.
So it's the Red Elephants of Gainesville. It's the Falcons of Flowery Branch. A region title is on the line. The All Access Pass pregame show is coming your way next, live on GPB. Welcome to Football Fridays and Georgia's All Access Pass. Tonight, all the marbles on the line. The championship in Region 8 5A is at stake as the defending 5A champions, the Red Elephants of Gainesville, take on the Falcons of Flowery Branch.
Tonight, we're coming to you live from City Park in Gainesville, Georgia. It is the perfect night for a football game, the perfect night to find out which of these two talented teams will walk away with a region championship.
You know, 20 champions have already been decided. 28 region titles will be decided this weekend.
This is it. This is the weekend to find out if you're going to be moving on in the playoffs. And it's a weekend when we want to hear from you about your favorite team. So let's check in with our social media correspondent, Grace Olson, with what people are tweeting about. Grace?
Thanks, Claire. That's right. This is the time of year when people really start turning up the volume around high school football. And region titles are on the line like tonight here in Gainesville. So things are really heating up on social media. Red Elephants senior quarterback Deshaun Watson is the state's all-time pass leader with 2,546 yards and 33 touchdowns, and he is all the buzz on Twitter. Now, he may be a Red Elephant now, but he is a Clemson Tiger commit, so we have tons of Clemson fans watching tonight. Fan Matt Morgan tweeted this photo of his two little kids saying, "Best of luck tonight, Deshaun, from your little Tiger fans." Now, this game is so big. Flowery Branch won it last year, but Gainesville won the state championship, so we've got Gainesville students taunting Flowery Branch fans by tweeting this photo of their state championship ring from last year. Look at that ring. It is dazzling. Now, when it comes to the Flowery Branch fans, the hashtag of the night is Dark Side. This student section actually calls themselves the Dark Side on Twitter, where I found out they'll be all decked out in black gear and black paint tonight. They tweeted this photo of a banner hanging from what looks like a nearby bridge, getting the community excited for tonight's game. It says Dark Side. Now, Dre Streedy, a student there, tweeted us this photo of a Falcons student all decked out, saying, "If you don't look like this tonight, you're not doing it right. Hashtag blackout, hashtag dark side." Now make sure to also like us on Facebook. I've got an album going. It's called Game Week, Flowery Branch versus Gainesville. So make sure to like that and check us out. And also, there are 12 other games around the state tonight that are going to determine the region champion. So you need to stay updated on those scores as they change throughout the night. The app also has schedules, and it has the latest news and rankings. And it is free. So download the GPB Football app from the App Store right now for your iPhone or your iPad. Mark, these guys need that app. Am I right?
Absolutely. It's playoff time. You want to keep up to date on your scores, and it's free.
Absolutely. Can't leave home without it, Mark.
You know, I can't believe this is the last game of the regular season. I don't know where the regular season has gone, but at the end of this weekend, 32 teams from each classification will move on into the playoffs.
And it is also senior night here at Gainesville, and every single high school has their own senior night traditions. Well, you've probably heard of Georgia Red Clay, but what about Gainesville Red Clay? Art class is about to begin at Gainesville High School. And behind this big red door is an even bigger collection of red elephants.
We have about 15 different molds of different size elephants. small ones, they're large ones.
The school sells the elephants to raise money for the art program, but these small ones are not for sale. These designs are reserved for senior night, a small red token of appreciation to graduating students, and a tradition that art teacher Joe Emery says goes back at least 30 years.
After about 12 years, maybe about 98, somewhere around there, we decided that they expand it. So instead of just athletics, they led into drama and the ROTC.
Senior Art Club member Badea Peñaloza says a lot of care goes into each pachyderm, from pouring the clay into the mold.
It gets really messy.
To letting it dry.
We sit this for 30 minutes.
There it is.
There we have an elephant.
Oh, wow.
And then carefully carving away any extra clay.
So each one, even though it comes from a mold, they really are kind of unique, huh?
Mm-hmm. We have elephants with wings. We have a lot of different elephants.
Now it's time to paint. Any tips?
Try not to get too messy.
Don't get too messy. Okay, all right.
Before our senior night elephants go home with their students, they need a coat of that famous Gainesville red.
Woo! All right, we're all done.
Yes, oh my God, they look awesome.
Oh, but now we don't have anything else to paint. Unless...
Whoa, what are you doing? Oh.
She told me not to get messy, but we threw that right out the window. And Mr. Emery told me that every year they make about 200 of these just for the senior students. He says there are probably thousands of them floating around the Gainesville community. And Mark, they even made one for you.
All right, I can't wait to get my red elephant. This is just a huge high school football game. Both these teams are on 7-game winning streaks. Both of these teams are unbeaten in region play. And both of these teams can light up a scoreboard. Let's check in now with our play-by-play team of Trey McDaniel and Keelan Johnson for a little chalk talk in a segment we call Extra Point. Guys?
Thank you very much, Mark. Mark, you said it perfectly. It's a huge game. A region championship is on the line. And, of course, in all big games, it comes down to what a few guys do on the football field. We're going to talk about tonight's difference maker, starting with Gainesville.
Well, first and foremost, Gainesville have a lot of players. You know, we're only going to do three so far. But what really jumps out to me, because I'm a defensive guy, Trey, both of us are, is J.D. Soulsby. He does so much on the linebacker position. Watch him in the middle position. He has a lot of range. He plays with enthusiasm. That's one thing I really like, what he brings to the table and to the enthusiasm of this defense. Next is Jamias Byrd. He does a great job in the running back position and stretching the field. He's a great complement to Mr. Watson, who's the one we're going to get to next, who does a lot with his arm, but he's the man he does a lot with his feet, but he's the man that carries the ball for him. And we all know Mr. Watson, the quarterback position is the most important position on the football field because you're the leader. Speed of the leader is the speed of the pack. This guy's going to Clemson, and he's the number one quarterback in the state of Georgia.
Well, they've got a number four, the Flowery Branch Falcons do as well, and it's Jackson McDonald. He is also their quarterback. He is not only their leading passer, but he's also their leading rusher.
Right.
And head coach for Gainesville, Bruce Miller, said that last season when Flowery Branch upset Gainesville, it was Mr. McDonald that single-handedly won that football game for him. Let's also talk about linebacker Kellen Clark. Not the biggest guy, not the fastest guy. He leads the team with 55 tackles. He's the emotional leader on defense. And then I'm going to go off script a little bit and talk about the entire offensive line. Mm. These guys are all A students.
Nice pick.
Their coach said they are the life breath of the football team. As they go, so goes the football team. Which one of these guys is going to be the main player in tonight's game? We'll have to tune in for kickoff. Until then, we'll toss it back over to Mark and Claire.
7:30.
Those guys are ready to go, aren't they? They do their research.
I think Trey cheated. I don't think you can pick the entire offensive line.
Man, they're all A students. That's the key. Coming up on our All Access Pass pregame show, one of the most infamous moments in TV football history, find out the Gainesville connection. And we'll touch base with Coach Bruce Miller of Gainesville and the all-time passing leader in the state of Georgia, the Red Elephants quarterback, Deshaun Watson.
Plus, we'll find out which Gainesville players have gone on to the greener pastures of pro football. That and much more as Football Fridays and Georgia's All Access Pass continues here on GPB.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more. And by viewers like you, thank you.
This is you. You're a Georgia high school student, full of fresh ideas and a desire to make a difference in your school and community. Well, now's your chance. GPB wants you to help stop the drop by showing us why it's important to stay in school. Grab a camera maybe a friend or two, and create a 30-second video PSA. Why do your peers drop out? What's a solution? All ideas are welcome. Check out the full details at gpb.org/stopthedrop and get going.
Let's go down to John Nelson, who's having a whole lot of fun. Is that John Nelson, a conductor? Yeah.
I grew up in DeKalb County, so I knew all about the reputation. World-renowned, high-powered, high-octane, and to get the chance to conduct that band on Football Fridays in Georgia, are you kidding me? To be able to climb on that ladder and get them through a number in one piece, it's one of the coolest things I've ever got the chance to do here at GPB. I cannot wait to see what this season brings. Go on to GPB Sports Facebook page and let us know some of your favorite moments.
This week on Georgia Traveler, we're all about strides and stallions. What kind of wildlife can we see out here?
We see lots of birds.
Oh yeah, a pelican passed by.
Isn't that
beautiful? Howdy, Georgia. Cowboy.
Welcome to paradise.
I hope this horse is enjoying this.
Main line drive left field.
Not gonna try that again.
Never seen anything like that.
From the mountains to the coast on the next Georgia Traveler.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
Tonight, the Kansas City Board of Education pays tribute to the genius of Phil.
Welcome back to our GPB All Access Pass pregame show as we get ready for the huge region championship game as the Red Elephants of Gainesville take on the Falcons of Flowery Branch.
Football fans of a certain age may not remember the exact date. It was November 17th. 1968, but they do remember the controversy. GPB's Bruce Burkhardt has more on this TV NFL controversy and the Gainesville connection.
It was one of the biggest debacles in the history of televised sports. It involved a hotly contested Sunday afternoon game between the New York Jets and Oakland Raiders, played in Oakland. Both teams were in top form, and the scoreboard was in constant seesaw motion as the teams kept scoring against each other.
The lead changed back and forth six times before the score was finally tied at 29-all. Then the Jets' Jim Turner kicked a 26-yard field goal, and the Jets had the lead with 1:05 left.
Meanwhile, NBC had been heavily promoting a kids' movie, Heidi, that was airing at 7 p.m. No one had ever considered what might happen if the football game ran long, but it did. So with just a little more than a minute left on the clock and the Jets up by 3 points, East Coast viewers suddenly found themselves watching kids and goats. Say what? NBC switchboards lit up like Chicago after Miss O'Leary's cow ran amok. The network tried running a crawl to update the score, but football fans were even more incensed when they saw that Oakland, down by 3 points at 7 p.m., had won the game by 11 points. Oakland scored 2 touchdowns in the last 9 seconds of the game, including a touchdown made by Gainesville High alum Preston Reidelhuber, who recovered a Jets fumble in the end zone. He's the one wearing number 37. And we should mention that football fans weren't alone in their fury. Heidi fans were appalled that football scores were running across the screen while Heidi's disabled cousin Clara was struggling to learn to walk. All the irate calls finally caused NBC switchboard to blow up. The network took a major shellacking in the press for days and weeks afterward, and it quickly changed policy to let all football games finish before moving to other programs. This day, Heidi is probably still a bad word at 30 Rock.
So who knew that Gainesville High School had a connection to such a memorable NFL moment? Well, the guy sitting next to me probably did. He's Alvin Richardson, the author of a new book on the history of high school football in Gainesville High. You probably knew a little bit about Preston Reidelhuber, huh, then that trivia?
Yeah, well, I had read all about it, but it was really cool to see the tape of it. I hadn't seen the tape before, so that was fun to watch. You guys did your homework there. Doing the book, I did get to read a lot about and study about Preston Reidelhuber and several of his teammates that have helped put Gainesville on the map.
Right. Well, the 1960s were a hot time here at Gainesville High School. You had one guy, Billy Lothridge, came in second in the Heisman voting.
That's right. And you know, coming in second to Roger Staubach's not too shabby company to be in. And, of course, that's a pretty good claim to fame for him and for the Gainesville program.
How about another guy, Billy Martin?
Billy Martin is, every time I go up to the Longstreet Cafe, they're talking about how good a football player Billy Martin was, and played tight end in the NFL. He was just a special guy. You know, you don't get to play in the NFL unless you're something.
Now, your book, Tracks of the Red Elephant, the 100 Years of Gainesville High School History, a big part of that is last year's 2012 state championship.
Right.
Talk about that.
Yeah, the first part of the book deals in pretty good detail with the championship season. It goes into as much detail as you could probably want. It talks about all the stats and all the kids that are on the roster and the coaches, and even the cheerleaders got in on the book. So I think it's something that the Gainesville community is going to enjoy for a long time to come, and hopefully their kids and grandkids will enjoy it as well.
What was the best part of writing this book and researching the book?
You know, I think meeting the people of Gainesville, getting such a great welcome from them. Coach Miller and his staff were really helpful, but I spent a lot of time with other community members who helped me to put some details together in this thing and add some flesh to what could have otherwise might have just been bare bones.
Alvin, if somebody wants to buy the book, Tracks of the Red Elephant, 100 Years of Gainesville High School History, how can they get a hold of you?
Right. Well, the best place to get it is at the Gainesville Times here in Gainesville, Georgia. They'll be selling it all the time during office hours. So going to the Gainesville Times office is the very best way to get it right now. And I'm selling them tonight at the ball game.
All right, Alvin Richards, thanks so much for coming on with us. Good luck with the book.
Thanks for having me.
All right, Claire.
Well, you saw the highlights there. The Red Elephants of Gainesville were able to walk away with that 5A state championship last year. And as any team would, they're hoping to do it again.
Right. Earlier today, I talked to Coach Bruce Miller and his standout all-star quarterback, Deshaun Watson. Coach, it's senior night. Talk about this guy next to you, Deshaun Watson, who has set all kinds of records in the state of Georgia. It's his senior night as well.
It sure is. And we're proud of Deshaun and proud of his accomplishments, but we still got work to do. Deshaun knows that. But this guy next to me has made the last 4 years very special.
Deshaun, the stats are unbelievable. Over 11,000 yards passing, 141 touchdowns. You've rushed for 52 touchdowns. You've even caught a couple of touchdowns. Is there anything you haven't done yet?
Win state back to back, and that's my goal. But first of all, you got to take care of tonight, the region championship, and then you can worry about the state. But that's my ultimate goal.
Did you think when you were a freshman that that your career would develop the way it's developed?
Not when I was younger. I didn't. But you know, as the coaches. As the season went by, and the coaches told me I have the opportunity to have the stats that I have now, and I just took advantage of it.
What's it mean to you, final time here at Bobby Groon Field as senior night?
It's great. I love this. I love this town and this city. You know, I do it. I can do it. You know, if I had a chance to do it all over again, and you know, I'm gonna cherish these moments for the last time, and you know, make this last time great.
Coach, Flowery Branch undefeated in the region. Gainesville undefeated in the region. Talk about this clash tonight.
Should be a tremendous ball game. You couldn't ask for a better setting. Both teams hadn't lost since September, and we get a chance to meet here for the region championship. What a great setting, what a great atmosphere.
Coach Miller, Deshaun, thanks for coming on. Good luck tonight.
Thank you, Mark.
Deshaun already holds all those records for passing yards and passing touchdowns, so every yard he throws for tonight, every touchdown, he just adds to the legacy. Now let's check in with Claire Sims and a special guest. Claire.
Thank you, Mark. I'm here with a familiar face here in Gainesville and down at the state capitol. This is Representative Carl Rogers of Gainesville. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for inviting me.
Now, I understand you know a little something about Gainesville.
I do. Been here all my life and mentioned those football players, Billy Martin, Billy Lothris, Preston Ryder, Huber, and you in person. Know him personally, and still in contact with some of them.
So tell me, for people who are watching at home who maybe right. don't know, you grew up here. How special is a night like tonight?
Well, Gainesville, traditional, 120 years. You know, the school system's been here, been playing football for 100 years. It's always been a highlight here in Gainesville proper and also in Hall County.
And you went to Gainesville High School. What are some of your most fond memories?
Well, my fond memories were the late Bobby Groon, who the field's named after, was my head coach, head football coach, and back in the early 60s, and did a great job. We moved up in the region. We didn't win that many games, and then we came back in the region, and they started winning again. So
now, Flowery Branch, big rivalry. They weren't around when you were in high school.
No, there was no Flowery Branch at all other than the town. So, the population growth we've had all over the county, that's where a lot of the population is today.
Gotcha. Well, thank you so much for being here.
You.
We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And good luck when the session starts in January.
Thank you.
All right. Now, ahead on the All Access Pass, we have a lot more that you're going to want to see. John Nelson back with a look at one of the great state rivalry games here in Georgia.
And we continue our Stop the Drop campaign and tell you about a way you could win a cool $1,000. We're getting close to kickoff at Flowery Branch, Gainesville and Flowery Branch, so don't go anywhere. We're back on GPB.
Are you willing to give a helping hand? If you're a Georgia high school student, you can enter GPB's video contest, win $1,000, and make a difference.
Sorry.
How can you help the drop?
One of my favorite moments for Football Fridays in Georgia was in the championship game when Norcross won the 6A title. I interviewed Alvin Kamara and the quarterback, Joseph Wilbur, who had just combined on the game-winning touchdown.
2015, a foot race. He's in touchdown!
We kept playing our game and kept pressing on, and we came out with the win.
If you could bottle that kind of enthusiasm, you could light the world.
Has it sunk in yet, really?
No, sir, not at all.
Log on to GPB Sports Facebook page and tell us about your favorite moments.
This week on Georgia Traveler, we're all about strides and stallions. What kind of wildlife can we see out here?
We see lots of birds.
Oh, yeah. A pelican passed by.
Isn't that beautiful?
Howdy, Georgia. Cowboy.
Welcome to paradise.
I hope this horse is enjoying this.
Hang line drive left field.
Not gonna try that again.
Never seen anything like that.
From the mountains to the coast on the next Georgia Traveler.
50 years ago, JFK is assassinated. Millions suspect a conspiracy. Can a modern investigation find the truth? Nova examines the evidence through the lens of modern day forensics. Cold Case JFK.
On Why Wednesday at 9, only on GPB.
Think all that homework won't lead to anything? If you're a Georgia high school student, you can enter GPB's video contest, win $1,000, and make a difference.
Did you mean to throw this away?
How can you help stop the drop? In one season, a team battles through 720 minutes of game time, measures 4,728 feet of cable and inches to go, produces 44 breakout runs and 97 righteous blocks, hopes for 15 happy endings and zero heartbreaks, to the sound of 8,653 noisemakers and overcomes 122 sweaty palms. We do it all for one day.
Welcome back to the All Access Pass. They've just played the national anthem. We're getting ready for Flowery Branch and Gainesville here on Football Fridays on GPB. Now, John Nelson has covered high school football in the state of Georgia for over 20 years.
He's
written two books on the subject.
Two.
So he brings you to our Stump Nelly segment.
Yes.
He's a know-it-all, but does he really know it all? So in this envelope, hermetically sealed.
Stuffed in a mayonnaise jar.
Stuffed in a mayonnaise jar. We have this week's question, and it is.
Yes.
Each of these Georgia high school teams had a perfect season within the last 10 years. Which team was the most recent to go 15-0?
Let's see if we can figure this one out.
Camden County, A, B, Chattahoochee, C, Grayson, or D, Lowndes?
Let's go with C, Grayson.
Grayson, and do you have any idea when that was?
I believe that was when we were at the Dome in 2011.
All right. Well, we couldn't stump Nelly this week. If you have a question to stump Nelly, you can send it via Facebook, via Twitter, and you're back on a winning skid, so you're doing okay.
I think it was the hat.
The hat, yes, the hat definitely adds something to the ceremony.
There you go. Thank you very much.
All right. You'll be right back, so we'll see you in just a second.
I got it.
Okay. One of our missions here at GPB is to raise awareness of Georgia's high dropout rate in high school. It's important to stay in school and to get that degree. For more on our Stop the Drop campaign, here's Claire Sims.
All right. Thank you so much, Mark. I'd like to welcome in George Epps. He's the program director of an organization called Youth on the Move. Thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
So tell me, what is Youth on the Move? It sounds fun.
Well, basically, it's an out-of-school time initiative in which we support middle school and high school students as they transition from middle school, of course, and hopefully aid them in graduating from high school on time.
And how do you identify the students who need your help or would benefit from your program?
Well, actually, we pride ourselves in keeping our resources in the heart of the community. Most of our students come from the Peoplestown community. There's only a couple who are probably in adjacent communities, and so basically it was word of mouth. We have different events in which we recruit students, etc. And so, but for the most part, they're all neighboring school students.
And I see that 89% of the students you work with are able to either maintain or improve their grades. What do you think is the real key to that success?
Just being a place of resources, having approachable adults and staff on site, volunteerism, where students feel comfortable to be able to come to us for being a place of resources. So I think we can attribute that to much of our success.
Now, if somebody wants to get some more information about your program, say they have a kid in the Peoplestown community who they think could help or could be helped by it, what can they do to get more information?
Well, basically, they can either go to our website. We can be reached easily, 404-524-0229, or they can go to www.youth-onthemove.org and email us, leave an email, let us know they're interested, or they can actually, our door is always open.
All right. Mr. Epps, thank you so much for being here, and thank you for the hard work you're doing in the community.
Thank you.
All right. GPB's Stop the Drop campaign aims to improve graduation rates across Georgia. Time's running out to enter this year's video contest. So high school students, you still have your chance all across the state. All we need you to do to participate is to create a 30-second public service announcement tackling the issue of why students drop out of high school and maybe offering encouragement to some of those children who are thinking about dropping out. It's really easy to do. All you have to do is go to gpb.org/stopthedrop for the full contest details. And people will be able to vote for their favorites, and we will reveal the winner during the championships in December. If your video is the winning video, you will take home $1,000. But remember, time is almost running out. The playoffs are almost here. We want to see that video, so go to gpb.org/stopthedrop for more information. Mark?
Thank you, Claire. Look who's back, the author of four books, 2-4-2 on high school football in the great state of Georgia. Segment we call John Georgia, brought to you by
Georgia's EMC.
All right, topic number one, the Fighting Irish of Aquinas, undefeated.
A lot of folks are talking about life in Jefferson Energy and Planters EMC. When it comes to the private side of single A, you're talking about Eagles Landing Christian. You're talking about Landmark. What about Aquinas? They're 9-0 coming into this week's action. You want to talk first quarter? Reuben Garnett goes all the way from the right-hand side of your screen to the left-hand side of your screen. 88 yards of picking them up and putting them down. 10-0 at that point over GMC. Liam Welch at quarterback. He's going to drop back. Watch this catch right here by Chris Lambert. High arcing shot. Nice catch by Lambert. Lambert will get some extra yak after the catch, and it sets up Shalom Alvarez catching the ball right there. 31-0. Aquinas, your winners. They are now 9-0 heading into tonight.
All right. Topic number two, a school wins its first ever region title.
And this is a cool story. We're going to spend some time in Flint Energies and Middle Georgia EMC for this one. And Veterans High, fifth-year program, a lot like Archer, getting their first shot at a region title. We caught up with head coach David Bruce and asked about signature wins, and he got one even earlier in the season.
It feels good. It feels good. Beating Westside, which is a quality program and one of my former employers, that was a good win for us. And I think it was the kind of win that gave our kids the confidence to know that, hey, we can win big games and we can win games against good programs.
That's it for topic two. It's topic three.
Topic three is Carver Columbus has a new coach, but they just keep on winning.
Del McGee gone. Joe Kegler in. We'll spend some time in Diverse Power Flint Energy's EMC. And Carver and Peach went at it last week for the 2-AAA region title. And it came out on Carver's, their behalf. The Columbia Blue touchdown pass right there. Noah Hickey, 2 yards to make it 16-0 right there at that point. Then Jawan Pass will go 26 yards next time out of the box to make it 22-0. 2-point was good. 44-9, the Columbia Blue get the win over Peach County. They are the number one seed, and we'll find out maybe later tonight who they play.
All right, and at halftime, you got a story about another undefeated team.
You want to talk about undefeated teams? We're going to go to Barnesville and catch up with Franklin Stevens and the Lamar County Trojans.
Can't wait. He'll be on the sidelines. Now back over to Claire.
All right, we are just moments away from kickoff, so now let's check in one final time with our social media correspondent, Grace Olson. Hey, Grace.
Thank you, Claire. I told you earlier about that Dark Side Lowry Branch student section, and here they are with me. Now, tonight... Okay, all right, now, you brought the blackout here tonight. Last year, let's show a photo right now. These guys blacked out last year when they played Gainesville. How do you think you're going to bring it tonight?
We are the loudest, the rowdiest, and the craziest student section in the nation. And we are amazing!
All right, let's hear it for these guys. Reed, you guys should know this team better than anyone. Give me the best playmakers on offense and on defense.
Well, I got to say, on offense, it's got to be our quarterback, Jackson McDonald. Tonight, you can expect to see him. He's a dual-threat quarterback. He's going to use his legs and his arm to take us to this victory.
Okay.
On the defensive side of the ball, we got to say Kellen Clark. He's our middle linebacker. He is definitely an impact player out there. You can expect him to bring it.
Okay, well, let's get a preview of how you're going to cheer on those Falcons tonight. Let me hear it. Back over to Mark on the set.
Wow, they said they are the best student section in the country.
I think they're ready to go.
I think so. It's that time. We are now counting down to kickoff.
All right, we got the Falcons of Flowery Branch. We got the Red Elephants of Gainesville. It's Football Fridays in Georgia. Kickoff time
live on GPB. GPB.